A pleasure to be all at last, and welcome back to some more bonus content here in Films I'm Willing to Talk About Again, because why not? Well, in all honesties, what I got to talk about here is something that I actually just saw on Netflix recently called The Bubble. This is, in fact, the one story about one particular building that is made for housing the entire cast and crew of a long-running in-film film series that is in fact made by the likes of a lot of people. And all of the people associated with the cast, crew, producers, directors, etc. are all in this one place while a pandemic is happening. And of course, the peak of the pandemic as we've known about it, while it's not necessarily canonically mentioned, especially when there's no dates that they showcase in the whole film itself, it's important to note the peak of the pandemic had happened, especially with the huge fatality rates that had occurred between January 16th and February 24th of 2021. It's a pretty long window, so a lot of people might think otherwise about when the peak of the pandemic had happened, but I for sure know about this sort of stuff. As a fact checker and honest analyzer of these different things, it's very important to know the details to these things, because a lot of people can make stuff up and usually get away with it. That's just how the internet rolls. Until we find a way to pretty much eliminate this sort of discourse that happens in all known cases of this kind of anomaly that we've seen for the past couple decades, we'll probably just have to continue living with this sort of stuff, with all the lies that people continue to post everywhere across the web. Every single code and byte that exists. The Bubble, however, is not necessarily just about the sum of what is happening. It's also meant to be about how is happening and why is happening. Because what happens here is that various actors and cast members, including the likes of well-known stars like Keegan-Michael Key, Karen Gillan, and Pedro Pascal, these guys all come together in a pretty unique way that gives us the combination of some sexcom, satire, drama, and all the other unique things that we've basically been putting together in all kinds of movies in recent years. A lot of people seem to be wanting more of this sort of content that's rated either R or NC-17, assuming if that's a rating that still exists. But yet, when looking at things the way that they are in this film, being a film that centers around early 2021, where the pandemic that we had just gotten out of was in fact at its peak, at the highest possible proportion of deaths, infection rates, hospitalizations, and other such cases revolving around this sort of disease. It's especially noteworthy to just find out the facts that happen anywhere. And I would definitely recommend some of the most reliable sources out there that portray the most information possible to talk specifically about this well-known virus. For nearly 3 years, we've had to deal with all of this. And just the fact that we're still going to be going through it for a long time, even though we're practically over it and it's kind of over in our area, the whole rest of the world still has to deal with it much more so than we ever will. Which is sad, sad, sad. And you know what? It's no surprise here that The Bubble is more or less just about knowing the fact that at some point in time, all of us have to basically step into a comfort zone. What of which nowadays we've been referring to as bubbles. As you probably know by now, your house happens to be the only considerable option for what's known as a bubble. The one thing that can separate you from the rest of the world from a potential viral outbreak of a virus that's known to kill millions of people all over the world. Many people are arguing right now about how the fatality rate is definitely not as high as it should be to consider lockdowns possible. But at this point, it doesn't even matter. Even just 0.00000000001% of fatality rates and the like, that would still be enough to cause lockdowns to happen, because who would want to sit and watch millions of people die before taking action? Obviously nobody. So in any way that you look at it, the bubble does give us a very, very accurate representation. It starts off with Karen Gillan arriving to the one building that she is supposed to come into to work on a new sequel for a long-running series of films that she had been a part of the production over the years. But because she was not present during the last film's production, everybody else whom she got to meet after a while simply decided to go full circle and full postal on her for practically no reason. Even after some apologies and after some reconciliation with the others, Gillan's character pretty much does not have a whole lot of hope, pretty much. And when getting to create another sequel for a long-running series, it's just a bit of tension and a bit of spite that can continue to take place. But any way that you look at it, though, this film gives us a whole lot of things out there. There's a lot of sex references in here, which certainly made me very discomforted in all possible ways. There's a lot of comedic relief that takes place, and who could ever forget the one moment in this one little piece where Karen Gillan is supposed to sit in a room for 2 full weeks before being allowed to come back out as some sort of test that happens. And in any way that you look at it, though, the fact that they actually went on ahead to try and give us a representation of what the 2-week-long quarantines were like back then, with all the people wanting to say that these were bad, it's actually amazing to keep you away from the rest of the world when there's a literal killer virus out there. Trying to be normal when a virus that kills millions of people is around would be as much sense that could be made as a terrorist attack that happens in the country, which has happened many times before then, and surprisingly not as much today. I mean, you would definitely want to remain indoors, safe at all costs. Even for weeks at a time, months at a time, I have certainly practiced for a long time. Like, since I was a child, I've kept myself in my own room, in my own house, in my own apartments, in my own anything that I've ever lived in my whole life. Just so I would not go crazy. With all the people insisting that we should go outside and have ourselves a life, it's just ridiculous for them to think that now at a time like this. And I could sure tell you that the bubble definitely gave us something right. What you should do when a pandemic is around, knowing the kind of PPE that's available for you, the kind of equipment that would be necessary from thermometers and regulators to bodily fluid analyzers. I mean, they showcase every nitty-gritty detail available, just to be as honest as real-life personnel would ever tell you. The CDC themselves sure have a lot of connection, and I'm definitely sure this film actually was endorsed by most of these organizations that are designed to help prevent disease and outbreaks from happening like this. But in the end, though, with a film that simply gives us a one-of-a-kind piece that's pandemic-based, the fact that you got so many people living in a building together, working together in a building, just to make another sequel for the film, the long journey that happens from the first moment that they meet each other in this one building where you're free to do whatever the heck you feel like, all the way up to the very moment where they actually go on ahead and have their own finished product set for release. And right then and there, this is pretty much what we get if we were able to have ourselves a life out there on an actual set while a pandemic is happening. And so, being that in 2021, we have seen so much of this stuff happen like this, people were confined to their own homes as requested by law. And, of course, the many lockdowns that had happened throughout all this time since 2019 and all of the other changes that we were able to see with our own eyes and hear with our own ears and just understand from a mental and physical viewpoint. We will never live life the same way again. We shall not look back at our own ways back then and use them today. We were just so dumb and just so disregarding for a lot of things out there including personal safety, health, and well-being, that we practically let ourselves go and we let this entire country fall victim to one of the worst possible viral outbreaks that had happened in history. Period. Of course, Spanish flu easily trumps this because of its high body count, which is still known to this day, but there's a good chance that this outbreak is going to have an even higher fatality count. A higher body count compared to this is probably not a surprising factor. I mean, since this has happened before, and it probably will happen more times than not, and we will definitely have pandemics that might be worse than this, I could sure tell you. Lots of things aren't going to be expected, but this film actually did ourselves a really, really good service. For once. And that is pretty much saying a lot, but that's just how I roll. My honesty, my significance, and my satisfaction to just simply watching films that absolutely have everything to do with the facts that have happened. A viral outbreak happened in 2019, spread over all the other sides of the world. Every single hemisphere, every single country, every single landmass ever to exist was covered in these viral organisms. And everybody has had at least one infection by this point. Every time an infection happens, as opposed to an affection, you basically encounter terrible symptoms and are forced to stay in your own home for a long period of time. That is just the truth about all of this. And for those people who are still unwilling to accept all of these facts that are clearly proven and backed by everybody nowadays, and people are always being conscious, alert, and mindful of their surroundings, whereas all the other people are just simply the minority in this case. They want to oppose all of this stuff. They want to make it like it never happened. They want to try and erase the history that has been established since October 4th, 2019, when all of this stuff started to begin with on the other side of this world. Deep down there in Oceania in Asia, the combination of Indonesia, Borneo, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, China, Philippines, Japan, Russia, Korea, and eventually every other part of the world that had gotten infected with this is simply put how all of this started. One country fell to every other part of the world in a matter of months. And so with that in mind, that's just pretty much all I have to say about this. But if you want to see more, go down to my channel, then make sure that you like, subscribe, comment, follow me on social media, and stay on the Hollywood side.